tongue in glory, his face I at last shall see. 'Twill be my joy through the ages to sing of his love for me. Sing it now! Oh, how marvelous, oh, how wonderful, and my song shall ever be. Oh, how marvelous, oh, how wonderful is my Savior's love for me. What a day that shall be. And what's that, 395? What is that? Try 395. 385. What a day that'll be. You sound beautiful, sing it. And I love that trumpet. We said the trumpet's coming. Brother Dave's doing a wonderful job. And Sister Jacini on the piano there, enjoy. God bless you coming to the organ. I tell you, it's coming. It's coming. And I'll tell you, we got more that's going to be happening. Amen. It's first time, Brother Dave, on the trumpet. Amen. A University of Tennessee College student. The Lord has answered our prayers. And this is what we've been desiring. We've been praying about. And God answered our prayer. God sent Brother Dave our way, miraculously through the Holy Spirit, how he directed us. Amen. And I've been meeting with him, studying the Bible with him, praying with him, and going over and over it. And this is what he wants, you know, and we thank the Lord for you. God bless you, Joaz, and love to hear that organ as well. And wonderful, wonderful. We're looking at here, 385. What a day that will be. Think about heaven. Sing out like you appreciate heaven. Amen. We don't praise God enough. Isn't that right? How many of you know you're going to heaven? Isn't it wonderful? Amen. God bless you. And if you don't know, I believe before you leave, you'll know. You know. I believe that. I believe people pray around here. Amen? Amen. You get it settled. Amen. Amen. All right. What a day that will be. Okay.
There is coming a day when no heartache shall come, no more clouds in the sky, no more tears to dim the eye. All is peace forevermore on that happy golden shore. What a day, glorious day that will be. There'll be no sorrow there, no more burdens to bear, no more sickness, no pain, no more parting over there. And forever I will be with the one who died for me. What a day, glorious day that will be. What a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see, and I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace. When he takes me by the hand and leads me through the promised land, what a day, glorious day that will be.
Wonderful, sounds beautiful, wonderful, wonderful. And I want you to pray. Oh, God, help every one of us. I want you to know I welcome you. I thank God so much for you being here. Welcome. We always want you to feel welcome. And you, if you're in the choir, make sure you got the altar service on the table back there. Make sure you got the altar service there. I asked Brother Tim to forward it to you by text as well. Thank you, Brother Tim. And I believe you all know what's going on this morning. And why? My, you sound so wonderful. My main thing is I want you to feel welcome. I want you to feel at home, and I want you to feel appreciated. And I want you to pray to God to touch your heart as they sing. Let's pray and pray for them as they sing. Would you? And Brother Dave, God bless you. Lord's got a special touch on his life. He's been used of the Lord, sent by God. Third year major in music, and I've desired this. God knows, you know, people pray. And God's answered our prayer with sending him our way. And you encourage him, and you say amen, okay? Don't be a dead, stale church, okay? Say amen when they sing, you know? All right, okay? Be a participator, not a spectator. We don't have to look like that crowd that lost two games in a row at UT, University of Tennessee. God ain't never lost. God never lose anything, okay? Okay? So we're on the winning side, friend, okay? We got Jesus on us, okay? Because our confidence is in him anyway. thank God we can have fun at a game, but I'm glad that's all we our hope's not in all that.
That's right.
Come on, friends. Amen. Let's bow heads in prayer, okay? Let's pray. Let's pray. And let's ask the Lord. And we joke and we cut up and we have a good time. But on the serious side, do you know people take that thing so serious and they got more energy for that than God?
That's right.
Pray for them.
That's right. That's right.
But they need help, friends. Don't laugh at them. Let's ask God to help them and save them.
Yes.
Save them from hell. Amen. Amen. Give them heaven as their home.
Amen.
And then we ought to pray the ones that are saved, just get right with God.
Amen.
Nothing wrong with loving the game, but when you love that more than Jesus, something's wrong.
Right.
Ain't one of them ball players died for you. It ain't no college died for you.
Amen.
Only one person I know that died on the cross for you, that's Jesus Christ.
Amen.
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 Amen. Let's pray. Father, thank you for Brother Dave, and pray the Spirit of God to come upon him and help him, Lord. You know he's been studying that Bible.
Yes,
you know I've watched him, how he's underlying the scriptures. And it's more than just performance. He wants to serve you.
Yes,
it's a joy to see him knocking on doors, trying to get people saved.
Yes,
it's a joy in the midst of so much around him wanting to live a Christian life.
Yes,
as a single young man. Help him, Father. Put a guard around him. And he wants to use his talent for you. And he knows we're an independent fundamental Baptist church. He knows what type of church. And he knows what he's counting the cost. And I thank you, Father, for what you're doing in his life. And we pray bless his future. And bless these precious people here today. They're so precious to come out to the house of God. And Lord, when they hear the words of them singing, I pray they'll learn to love you more and realize how much what you've done for them, what you've done for us. May it be a blessing to us all. But most of all, we want it to be a blessing to you, Jesus. That's the main thing. We pray. Thank you for, I see my brother Ben coming in, dear Lord. I pray you change his schedule on his job. And Lord, he gets that bass guitar and he'll be able to play that instrument as he serves you. And so pray for brother Ben. Use him. And may his talent be used as well. And that'll be answer our prayer. Thank you. I see my brother come through that door. That's such an encouragement. The miracle, what you did in his life a year ago. People would not know a year and a half ago. That they have no idea. But God, you're helping them.
Yes.
I pray you continue helping them. Help them keep fighting.
Yes.
Don't give up. In Jesus' name. Thank you for the church that encourages them. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. You can be seated. God bless you. Make sure his mic's turned all the way up back there. Okay? Thank you.
Say thanks for the things you have done for me, things so undeserved, yet you give to prove your love for me. The voices of a million angels could not pleasing more to thee.
Let everybody stand, please. Thank you so much, Brother Dave. And the Lord has so much blessed us. Would you turn this pulpit mic up, if you will? I appreciate it so much. Thank you so much. This pulpit mic, this blue mic here, okay? Pulpit mic. Okay, let everybody stand, please. Everybody stand. Still ain't right for some reason, okay? Let everybody stand, okay? Let's try this. I'll tell you what. We'll try this cordless mic. We'll come back to the cordless mic. It sounded better. Okay. All right. I want to welcome everybody once again. We have the bulletins. Brother Tim, you have the bulletins. We're going to get them out in the hands of the people. Okay. You got the bulletins there. All right. Okay. Good. Wonderful. We're going to get you a bulletin. You can be seated. You can be seated. We're going to get you the bulletins in a couple of minutes. Great. Okay, let's go with this mic here. Okay. We're going to get you a bulletin in your hand in a moment here, okay? And there'll be a welcome on the bulletin. And one of my main concerns is once you get your bulletin, you'll see that it's very important to me that you know that I appreciate you taking your time out to be in part of our service. I don't take it lightly. You could have stayed home. You could have went shopping. You could have. There's a lot of things you could do. But it encourages that God's man that you're making decisions that's going to help you. God's man is a minister for God to you, to love you, to care about you, to help you. It's like a doctor that knows that he can help you. He knows he can help you. But he's encouraged when you're taking care of your health. You're taking care of yourself. You understand what I'm saying? And by you coming to church today, that's a blessing to say. I want to say thank you. Because you treat my Lord right. And when you treat my Lord right, that encourages me. I like it when you please the Lord. Because I love the Lord. I love him. And you know, he loves you. And there's a lot of people that love the Lord. Amen? And so I want to thank you. I can use a bulletin here. Others might need a bulletin if you can get me a bulletin. And who else needs... Well, we want to make sure you got a bulletin, okay? Who else needs a bulletin? You like me, you didn't get one yet. And just raise your hand if you need one, okay? All right. You see, visitors, what an important blessing it is you're here. I've been to churches I didn't feel welcome. That's sad. I want you to feel welcome here. I want you, okay? You are somebody special to us. Raise your hand, visitors. We want to make sure we recognize you're visiting with us. Let's cheer them on. Courage. Let's encourage these visitors. God bless you. Lord bless you. We're so glad you're here. Thank the Lord for you. Appreciate you. If you could put that business card in the bulletin, and I will encourage you to be faithful to all these services tonight. Tonight. I love it. Choir practice. My, oh, my. Choir. I love it. Trumpet. Brother Dave, what a blessing it is. My brother Ben, raise your hand back here. That's my brother Ben. He's not my twin, okay? He's my older, old man brother. No, I'm just joking. He's my younger brother, okay? And that's Brother Ben. And you pray. I want you to pray for his schedule and his job. You'll believe the miracle in a year and a half how God has been blessing Ben and helping Ben. And Ben, you know, the main thing I want you to pray for right now is job schedule. And you wouldn't believe a year and a half. You just wouldn't believe. God has just worked a miracle. He's a miracle just being here. But he plays that bass guitar. Brother Dave, I guarantee you that song that you sang, oh, it's unbelievable. I can hear the bass in there. I used to play bass guitar. As a matter of fact, when he starts playing, I think I'm going to get back into it. And he's going to show me some notes. And I'm a couple notes, Brother Ben. I believe I'll play some notes here and play some notes on it. And just maybe Brother Burley will buy a drum set. If not a drum set, some type of, you know, some type of relating to the drums. I don't know what they are, but Brother David get with you. And he'll get them cymbals. And I'll tell you, just don't tell what God will do here if it's not a whole set. But I'm telling you, you never know what God's going to do. Don't worry about it. We're not gonna rock and roll you from the devil's music or anything like that. But it's going to be heavenly music, better than the devil's music. You know right? But we're gonna do it for the Lord. You know right? But pray for Brother Ben's schedule. Pray for Brother Ben his schedule and a job. God's able to get him, you know, either a better job, or he'll work and change his schedule where he can be faithful. Brother Dave has been going soul winning, Sunday morning, Sunday night, Wednesday evening. He's been just. I've been studying the Bible, praying with him, and he's been really growing. And we thank the Lord for you, Brother Dave. We appreciate you so much. And give Brother David some encouragement and thank God for him and give him a hand, a little blessing. I know Jacinia rejoices. We're just wearing Jacinia out so much. And God bless you, Jacinia. I know there's times it's been overwhelming. But you want to know, sister? God knows. You know, now it's teamwork, see? But we ain't gonna stop with Brother Dave. We want more. We're gonna get some more instruments. We're gonna get some more different people singing. God bless us with this year also. Sister Nathan Lane and her family. What a blessing they've been. They joined the choir and this year. And Sister Nathan Lane, believe it or not, she sings some solos. So she get all nervous now. But we're gonna plug her up with a solo pretty soon. And one of these days, anyway. But thank the Lord. God is answering prayers. Isn't that right, Brother Burley? It's a joy. And Brother Burley rejoices. Brother Burley rejoices. He realizes help. Brother Dave, 3 years, a music major, it'd be a help, encouragement to Brother Burley. Brother Burley welcomes it. He welcomes it. And there's no telling. And the special groups, I'm looking forward to that. Where's Maricel at? Where's she at? Maricel, raise your hand. She's trying to be shy over there and hide. But in school, she's playing an instrument, a clarinet, whatever. If you play an instrument, let me know. If you find some of these kids playing instruments in school, you let me know, okay? And some of y'all want you to start taking some of this, whether it be flute, whether it be violin, whether it be whatever, guitar, drums, or whatever it is, trumpet. Oh, before Brother Dave came, by faith, we went out 2 months ago. I believe about 2 months ago, bought two brand new trumpets. Now, I know Brother Tim used to play trumpet, and Eddie has such a desire to play. Brother Johnson, Eddie has that desire. So that's the two that we're going to use for now. Now, raise your hand, little Henry. We'll raise the other $300. We'll pay $300 for each of those trumpets, but we'll raise it in church. There'll be people the money to give money. We'll go back to that place to get one more trumpet for Henry, because his desire, actually, him and Eddie, when they see the trumpets, they both going back and forth, who's gonna have it, but and work with it and practice. So, but that third one, Brother Henry, and if there's a fourth, we'll raise the money for that one, okay? And but for whatever instrument they want to play, we'll raise the money. But the main thing is we want to do it for God. We want to do it for Jesus. Amen. Isn't that wonderful, Brother Johnson? Brother Johnson's feeling better this morning. I'll tell you, Brother Johnson, how much we love him. Would you raise your hand, Brother Johnson? He's up in age. I told him. Now, I want the church to get on to him. I got on to him. I want you to get on to him and love him and care about him. Say, look, come on. This man is working so much a job during the week. Now, Sister Johnson, I told him, hey, listen, and God's going to take care of Brother Johnson. God's going to bless him. I believe that when he takes this step of faith. But he's just wearing himself out during the week, you know, and then Sunday. He's sickly right now. But I want you to pray. God's going to take care of you, Brother Johnson. We're here to help you. The church will help you. You let us know what needs you have. We'll do what we can. You know that. And encourage your daddy. We want him on Sundays. All we want Brother Johnson to do is serve God in church. Take care of us. That's it. That's what I want you to pray for. And I want you to pray for Brother Johnson. And I know what he's trying to do. He's trying to, you know, they're just, and Brother Johnson, we all have bills. We're swamped. We're all swamped, okay? All right? But we're going to pray for you, okay? And I know for a fact, and you believe it too, friend, that once Brother Johnson takes this act of faith, we're going to see his remaining days. I want him to enjoy his remaining days. Now he might outlive me. The Bible says you live to be 70. He's 70. But by strength, 10 more years. I hope and pray God give you. Brother Eddie, pray that God give your daddy 10 more. Okay? But then after that, I'll pray for 10 more. But Brother Johnson, you got to pray that God give me 10. You might outlive me. You might outlive some of these teenagers. But I'll tell you what, when you reach 70, it shouldn't be this way, Brother Johnson. People say in 70, we need to take it real serious and live like it could be our last. But there's some children that die, teenagers that die. Every one of us should live like it could be our last day. And that's all that's going to last, what we do for the Lord. Right? God bless you all. God bless you all. We're going to get ready to receive our offering. Let's stand, please, okay? If you could put your visitor's card in the offering plate, I appreciate it. We're going to get ready to receive our offering. If you need to use the table back there, the chair there, Brother Lauren, thank you. If you can make sure that's always cleared off for me, that whole table, nothing on that table there. Thank you, nothing on there. All that stuff off and all of it, even the offering plate. Brother Tim would be sitting in the chair. And what you can do is walk back there. They're going to be singing a special. And you can let Brother Tim, you know, you want to give by debit card, credit card, whatever way you're going to do it. Some people don't carry cash, don't carry checks anymore. God has miraculously, I know some of you wonder, how do we exist? You look around here, you say, how do we do it? How do we get our bills paid? Well, I want you to know there are some working people that tithe, that give, that work very hard. Or we wouldn't be having no air conditioner right now. You know, we won't have any electricity. We have no mortgage. We have no insurance. It goes on and on and on. And I know you wonder how miraculously God uses us that work. Let me hear you say W-O-R-K. There's some people that tithe 10% and give an offering. Okay? Now watch this. I'm going to be honest with you. After we've done all that we can do, if we didn't get that online donation from people that used to come here, some of these young people have moved out of town, they have forgotten about us. Friends, there's just no way. We won't be able to meet our needs. But God touches their hearts. Something may come in the mail. $100 here, $200 here, $80 here. It adds up. Brother Tim sees the numbers. Brother Brilliant, this ain't our regular offer. He sees the numbers. You see? And but sometimes God blesses us. He does. And guess what happens? We put an extra in. Amen. We put an extra in. We do. And by the way, sometimes you can't do it. Guess what God's going to do? Touch somebody else. God is, you're praying. God's doing something special. I got so many phone calls this morning. People wanting to ride to church. They want to come. Amen. A number of them. Amen. They stop calling. Amen. God's helping us. Amen. You know, you precious ones. God bless you. And I want you to pray the Lord to continue providing our needs. It's like that every month, you know. And pray. Pray for people that are sick. And Sister Payne, we're praying for you. You've been sick. It's a joy to see you here. And you've been sick. Brother Johnson in the back of you. But when we see you come in here, it's such a joy that God's answering our prayer, you know. And we're going to pray for you. God will touch your body and heal you, you know. And I got my oil. I want to make sure I have my oil. The Bible says anointing of the oil will pray and heal the sick. Raise them up. If anyone committed sins, God will forgive. God will forgive. Got the oil. Amen. Anybody afflicted? You say, I'm afflicted. Well, before you leave, let me put some of that oil on your forehead and pray over you. You say, you afflicted? Well, you make sure you see me before you leave. I'm not going to lie to you like some of these preachers say there's something in there. No, no. God has it. Amen. This oil represents what God has. Amen. So don't try to steal this. Pour it all over you. Put it all over your house. That represents the God, the Holy Spirit. Oil, you know, sheep, you know, talk infections, sickness, you know, talk about, and medicine, you know, and God says, I'm the medicine. Amen. So it's not in me. It's in your faith, our faith in him. Okay. So just like I told Sister Payne, we'll that's right. When you come, we'll, amen. Isn't that right? Okay. All right, my friends. And so we're going to get ready to receive our offer. Brother Burley always encourages us and challenges us. What a blessing it is. Thank God for him. God has supernaturally blessed him. He graduated from University of Tennessee. That's encouragement, Brother Dave here, University of Tennessee. We got another college student, I believe, from University of Tennessee you invited that's here this morning. Graduate. Would you raise your hand? Right over here. Give him a hand. Encourage him. And Brother Dave, isn't that wonderful? Who else? Who's that? Where's she at? Sister Z. Oh, yeah. Sister Z. Oh, she's here. Amen. She is here. Another one. Praise the Lord. Amen. God bless you. I didn't know she was here. Let's encourage her on. Wonderful. Three. Good. And my brother really graduated from University of Tennessee, Sister Patrice. And the Lord has just blessed them. Blessed them. You know. He knows I don't do this to brag on them, and they don't want no glory. They don't want, the only reason why I'm doing this, they know I want to encourage these University of Tennessee students. I don't think there's anyone in this auditorium that could match their salaries. Anyone. Matter of fact, it most likely triple yours. Now hold it. Don't try to hit them up for a loan. They're paying off loans. Okay, the more you have, the more you create. You create, okay? But they're paying, God's helping pay their bills. Okay? They have needs just like anybody else. But beautiful house, beautiful transportation. But what's more than that is the beautiful family. God bless them well. And the peace and the joy they have. And to be able to enjoy their marriage. That's more than money. Where people that have millions and billions of dollars can't even keep a marriage. And when, as you grow older, you're going to find the only thing that matters is that you have peace and you have joy. And you don't end up in misery, hating life, and not enjoying your work. Okay? But I encourage the University of Tennessee students to know that they put God first. And they serve the Lord, and they tithe 10% of their income, and an offering. Where the Bible says God will open your windows of heaven, there will be room enough to receive it all. Everybody's gonna have problems, but God's helped you with their problems. Everyone has bills, but God will help you with those bills. You know, and He's able to look back at life and rejoice that He just, as the pastor, as I preached, He applied it, and still applies it. And even as I speak right now, there are needs right now. Right now, both of them got tremendous big needs. But you know what? I'm encouraging you while you're encouraging them. Just keep doing what you're doing. God's going to take care of those bills. There always will be bills. Christian school, kids went through Christian school. College, they've graduated, but He's helped them. You know, when they get married, He does what He can. Sisters, they're just giving people. Give and it shall be what? Man, I'll tell you what. If there is a family that God is using our church as a pastor to be example, as my assistant pastor, I want to say thank you. And I share him with you. You know, he's teaching Bible training at 6:30 tonight. It's one of my highlights. It's one of my highlights. Just listening to him. 6:30 tonight. So I think I said enough, Brother Burl. I believe all you got to do is pray, really. You're the walking Bible around here, so you go ahead and pray. Okay.
All right. Like I said, like your pastor said, Brother Tim will be back here in the back here if you want to use your credit card, debit card, and tithe tonight, today with that. And there should be offering envelopes right in front of you. And just designate where you want to your offering to go to this morning, okay? But let's go to the Lord in prayer. We're praying and ask the Lord to bless us and provide every need, okay? Father, we thank you, Lord, again, that we can come before you and thank you, Lord, for your mercy and your grace. We thank you for the salvation you're giving to us, dear Lord. And thank you, Lord, for this opportunity we can just to show you how much we appreciate you this morning of all that you've done for us, how you died on the cross, paid the price for our sins, given to us eternal life. And Lord, we just want to let you know we love you, we appreciate you. And I pray you bless us this morning. You've been so good to us, dear Lord. Let us live today, waking us up this morning, Lord, sparing us, dear Lord, give us another day. And I pray you bless these precious people this morning. I pray you speak to every heart through God's word, and may you get the glory and the praise from it all. And we ask these things in Christ's name we pray. Amen. You may be seated.
God bless you. Before you play the piano, we got two that came in back here. We're so glad. Let's give them a hand. God bless you. Deani, welcome. You guys got your friend here. God bless you. We love you. So glad you're here, okay? Appreciate you. All right. God bless song, but Dave, he looks me up, but that's a powerful song, and you make sure you text that to me when you're ready to sing it, and you put ready on there for me. What a song. But then I can hear that bass guitar in the background. It ain't going to be long, man. I can just hear it in the background. My, oh, my. Let's bow our heads in prayer. Pray for these that are going to be ministering to us. Let's pray the Spirit of God would help them as this group comes, and thank God so much for them. Let's bow our heads in prayer, okay? And if you need to go by the table there and give back there by debit card or credit card, Brother Tim will swipe it that way if you're going to give your tithes and offerings that way at the back table. He'll be back there in a few minutes, okay? Let's pray. Let's pray, shall we? Let's ask the Lord to help us, okay? Let's bow our heads in prayer, if we will. Pray to the Lord to use a song to encourage you. And pray for these that are getting ready to sing. Pray the Spirit of God to help them. Okay? And I appreciate it so much you pray for them. Let's bow our heads in prayer. Let's close our eyes. And Father, we thank you so much and ask you to please bless these that about to sing and help them, Holy Spirit, to be used in a wonderful way. Father, I ask in Jesus' name that you be glorified and praised, and that you would help everyone to pay attention to the words of the song. And I pray, dear Lord, that you help these that sing. Spirit of God, I pray that you would use them and help them, encourage themselves and encourage others, and help us to give our best to love you and serve you. Thank you. We see Deanna come in. And God, just remember when she was just a little toddler, little junior, on those roller skates in Green Hills. Now she's an adult. Help her to realize we love her and miss her. So many of them grow up so fast. I pray this morning and encourage her heart and her family, what her family means to us. God, we pray for them. Bless them. I pray for her daddy. I ran into him in the store in Pilot. I pray you touch his heart and help him, dear God, and it'd be a blessing that he come to church and that I can be a blessing to him, help him, and that her mama, I know she loves her mama. I pray for all of our families. God, you touch them and help them. Different places that they're at this morning. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen. All right. Wonderful. Up. I don't care if you hear squealing. You need to hear them, okay? Don't be scared. Don't be scared of the sound system, okay? You need to turn things up, all right? They sang beautiful. They sang wonderful. The reason why we put this money into the sound system is so that they can be heard. And there's people that sacrifice money for these new mics. And use them, okay? Use them. And you make sure the choir mic is only up, okay, when they get ready to sing. Let's everybody stand. Choir's going to get ready to sing and come up on the last verse. Let's stand, please. Thank you for singing. You're doing a wonderful job. I appreciate it so much. Dwelling in Pure Land, page 320. The choir is going to come up on the last verse. Let's stand, please. 320. Thank you. 320. 320. I think most of you guys, you got it pretty much back there. Just to turn everything up, you know, the master up and everything, until you start hearing squealing. Amen. Always remember something back there in the sound. Look up here. Look up here. Hey, if it's not loud back there, look. If it's not loud back there, you know, If it's not love back there, that means you need to get it love. Okay. All right. Okay. Wonderful. Thank you so much. Okay. Dwelling in Beulah Land. All right. What we're going to do, and thank you, Brother Bill, you're going to help me with that. Sister Patrice, the schedule will be up. Okay. And you can talk to me, Brother Bill, if you need me. But we'll put it up. And we're going to find out who's supposed to be back there that week. And bless God, we're going to help them. Encourage them on. Get some practice in. Oh, Sunday night, whatever. Wednesday evening. Find out what we'll look in history. Find out what needs to be proved. That's the only way we're going to get right. You know, right? Amen. Thank God for the sound man. By the way, thank God for him. It's a tough task back there. Really? It's not easy. A lot of buttons back there. Amen. So we appreciate him. Dwelling in the Beulah Land, 320. 320 choirs will come up on the last verse. Good, thank you. Far away the noise of strife upon my ear is falling. And then I know the sins of earth be set on every hand. Doubt and fears and things of earth. Trumpet with the sound of a trumpet. God bless you, Brother Dave. And by the way, I believe there's going to be singing. God sings. You're singing when we're caught up in the clouds and meet the Lord in air. What a wonderful day that's going to be. We're singing, friend. We're singing because we have something to sing about and to be thankful for. And I want you to pray for the choir. Thank you so much, okay? Tonight, I'm not going to preach a real long, long sermon. Some of you will be real encouraged about that. Okay? And so it's going to be short for real this time, by the grace of God, for real. Because, you see, we got different groups that's going to be practicing, and they got to have their practice. And so I'm going to cut my sermon shorter. Okay? So I want you to take advantage of that, you that them long, long, long ones waiting out. Okay? So we're back tonight. Because after the service, our workers are going to be doing some work. We got work to do, workers, okay? We got plenty of work to do, so plan on that, all right? What I mean is you get out the regular time and do it Sunday night, okay? But we're just going to get some things done, all right? Okay? Brother Dave, what a blessing it is. Like I said, Brother Tim used to play trumpet. We got two brand new trumpets. Give Brother Tim some time to practice with you. And also Eddie wants to practice. And then if Brother Henry wants to really keep that energy up, we'll get a third one if we have to. All right, let's bow our heads in prayer, okay? It ain't gonna be long. Brother Ben's gonna get that bass guitar and show up with practice, and after he's get some schedule change on his job there, okay? And then Candace Rose, my daughter back there, it'll blow your mind the talent that she got right here. We're gonna pray your schedule too work out right, and get your schedule to work out right. And there's no telling, amen, what God's gonna do. Amen. There's no telling what God's going to do. Amen. We'll get Brother Ben back on the soul winning trail. Amen. Getting soul winning. We'll get together on your schedule. All right, Candace, on your schedule. We got some soul winners out here. Amen. Brother Johnson, God's going to work this schedule out, man. Amen. We're going to go soul winning. Sister Johnson, we're going to get y'all back in the choir. Amen. We're going to get you back. Amen. But on the serious side, pray for their schedules. These are some wonderful people, and we love them. And we just need to get their schedules adjusted on their jobs and things like that, okay? All right? And that's my daughter, Candace Rose. She's my Candy. I love my daughter. I love them all. They're all precious. And I thank God for them. You know, it's just a blessing that God's been so gracious and merciful to us all. We're undeserving of all his blessings. Isn't that right? Let's pray. Father, I love these people. This church is so special to me. I pray you bless them. And I pray that you bless the singers. I pray you pour your spirit upon them. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you. You can be seated. Okay, come on. You can be seated.
Sing it!
Come on, choir! Praise God. Let me even say, let the Lord be magnified. God. Psalms 51. This cordless mic, if you can turn this cordless mic up. This cordless, Psalms 51. Psalms chapter 51. Let's stand, please. If you can, respect the reading of God's word. Thank you, choir. Thank you, Brother Burley. I always try to publicly let you know how much I appreciate you and how God is using you to direct the choir. And they have a holy man of God like you that God has blessed us with in our church. We want to say thank you for that. And I want to say appreciate that. It's not easy coming to practice and getting here at 6 o'clock. You pick people up before you get here. It's not easy. And we know that. But thank God that the Lord helps you when you want it. And choir, I want to thank you. It's not easy getting to practice tonight at 6 o'clock. Choir, would you do me a favor? Would you pray the Lord to help you? Okay, choir? Choir, I'm asking you to plan on 15 minutes early. You say, why? So that you can get here at 6 o'clock. If you say 6 o'clock, you're going to get here at 6:15. But we need to tighten up, okay? You're doing a wonderful job, but we can do so much better. But we need to do it for the Lord, isn't that right? Would you stand, please, Psalms 51? Respecting the God, respecting the word of the Lord here. Brother Bill is going to read verse 1. And you're going to read every other verse down through verse 12. When I say Psalms 51, every Christian ought to already know what it is. If I say Psalm 51 and you don't know what it's talking about, you're missing it. You're missing it. You're missing it in life. Everybody ought to know what this is talking about. If we're going to help people, if we're going to help ourselves, this is the psalm. I'm telling you that if there's a psalm, King David, of all his blessings, of all that he's done in life, Psalm 51, when you read this psalm that helped him, and it either make you or break you in life. I'm telling you, this psalm is going to help you. Everybody's going to need it, and everybody's going to need it for ourselves and to help people and to care about people. We got a city in Knoxville that needs help. We got to help ourselves so we can help them. Right? But we got to help ourselves first. How are we going to help others? We got to get ourselves right. Right? That's all of us, right? That's why we're in church, right? Church is not a museum, you know, for saints. It's not a museum, but it's a hospital for sinners. We all need to be worked on. Amen.
Okay. Remain standing there and turn to Psalm 51, and we'll read here verses 1 through 12, and we'll read these verses responsively. And I read the first verse, and you read the second verse, and so on, all the way down to verse 12. Psalm 51. Have mercy upon me, O God, according to thy loving kindness, according unto the multitude of thy tender mercies, blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I acknowledge my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against thee, thee only, have I sinned and done this evil in thy sight, that thou mightest be justified when thou speakest and be clear when thou judgest. Behold, I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Behold, thou desirest truth in the inward parts, and in the hidden part thou shalt make me to know wisdom. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. May be here the joy and gladness, that the bone which thou hast broken may rejoice. Hide thy face from my sin, and blot out all my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit. Let us pray at this time. Father, we thank you again for the reading of thy word. We thank you, Lord, for blessing us to be in the house of God once again. And now, dear God, we pray that you bless the preaching of the word of God. We pray you fill path with the Spirit of God, that you give him power and wisdom and fill with the Holy Spirit to preach the word of God. Open our hearts this morning, Lord, to receive what you have prepared for us this morning. And may, dear God, most of all, that you be glorified and magnified through it all. And we ask these things in Christ's name we pray. Amen. You may be seated.
October 6th. Say October 6th. Even so, come quickly. Even so, come quickly. October 6th. My grandbaby's inside. I told Joy, that's my grandbaby in there. Make sure you feed that grandbaby. She's doing a good job feeding that grandbaby. Somebody say amen. Thank you. Thank you, Lauren. Y'all feeding my grandbaby there. But Joy, I know you want the baby to come today, but you got to wait to October 6th or before, okay? We're going to pray God give you grace. She looked like she's about to have the baby. But Joy, that's okay? Everything's in God's time, okay? Just keep on singing and praising the Lord. Thank every one of you that minister. What a blessing it's been. What a blessing. How God is blessed, you know, and now the most important part of the whole morning is God's word. See, you talk to God, you pray to God, and I believe we got people in here that do pray. I believe you do pray, but now it's time that God talks to you. It should not be just a one-way conversation. You do all the talking. Now God is talking to you. He said, "Well, two or three are gathered together, and there's more than two or three here. Jesus is here, invisible. He made your eyes; he can see you. He made your ears. He can hear you. You see? You understand now? But you got to sense his presence. You got to claim his presence. And you're a child of God. You have the Holy Spirit living inside of you. And he talks to you. He talks to you through the Word, talks to you through the Holy Spirit. So Psalms chapter 51, I want you to see here in verse 1 as we read this here, this psalm, have mercy upon me. If you have not ever prayed that prayer, you need to do it now because you're overdue. You're overdue. I'm not saying you did what David, King David did. It's an awful thing he did. Are you listening? I want you to listen. I mean, it's hard to imagine how a person can do this, being saved. But you got to learn, even though you're saved, you got to learn. You got to guard yourself, no matter who you are. Once you're saved, you have eternal life, you're going to heaven, you're a child of God. Okay, that's never going to change. You can't change that. You can't change a birth. You're in the family of God. Once you're saved, you're always saved. You have eternal life. The Bible calls it eternal life. Let me hear you say eternal life. But you got to learn to pray for mercy. And if it wasn't for the mercy of God, every one of us would go to hell, number one. But even after being saved, There are sins. 1 John chapter 1. If we say that we have no sin, we're liars. We deceive our own. You got to confess your sin. He's faithful and just to forgive you for your sins. Every day, we need to humble ourselves. We will not stop sinning. I'm talking about the old nature until we go to heaven. Now, the new nature, we got Jesus in us, the Holy Spirit. You know, that's the part that cannot sin. But we still have this flesh, friends. We still have this human body. We still got a battle. You understand? I'm not saying we'll do what David did. I mean, good night. This was after Bathsheba's situation with adultery. This is after he had her husband killed, a good man. His best man killed. Took his wife. It's a terrible thing. It's a terrible thing. It's a terrible thing. And we can choose. Are you paying attention? We can choose our sins, but we cannot choose the consequences. Amen. That's up to God. That's up to God. God chose that the baby, when it was born, to kill the baby. Not the devil. We're talking about God. God, the Lord giveth, he takes away. By the way, it's only by the grace of God in heaven us. Anybody better than anybody here? We're all a bunch of sinners. Saved by the grace of God. Or unsaved, going to hell and burn forever. And pay for those sins. By the way, it's not because you're a sinner, it's because you reject the blood of Christ. Jesus died, was buried, and rose from the dead. If you go to hell. We can choose our sins. Can't choose the consequences. I mean, he didn't plan for his son to be a rebel, try to kill his daddy. Nobody wants to go through that. I don't. Your own son trying to take your job and bring the gang boys, the gangbangers, kill you. Hey, that's no picnic. And of course, God took care of that and his son died. And David wished he could have died for his son. And said, I wish he would have killed me or I'd have died before him. That's how much love he had for his son. There's some parents, they don't even know what love is. Sometimes we don't even know what love is. I love you. You can love somebody that's trying to kill your own son and be willing to die for him. That's when we learn how to love. True agape love. We can choose our sins, but we can't choose our consequences. To have your own son rape your daughter. Please don't talk. I don't want you to go through a bunch of type of hell in life. I want you to avoid things. I want you to get the best in life. I don't want you going through unnecessary grief. For his own son to rape his daughter, for the brother to rape the sister, and to have the other brother get mad to kill his brother. So you got a brother that killed that brother. You got to go to the funeral, and then you got to miss your other son who ran away. Nobody wants to go through that. We can pick our sins, but we cannot pick our consequences. When a disease came upon him, some believe gonorrhea, syphilis, some sexual transmitted disease, where he almost died. Agonizing, screaming, pain, aching, crying, filling your bed up with wet tears. We can pick our sins, but we can't pick our consequences when the doctor says we got an incurable disease. And by the way, it was incurable until God cured it. Somebody say amen. Amen. Somebody say amen. See, we can choose our sins, but we can't choose our consequences. I just ask us to man up when God says these are the consequences. Warm it up. Just say, hey, I'm not going to be selfish anymore like David. I'm going to ask God for mercy. If I got what I deserve, I go to hell. I never deserve that the experience to see this baby born anyway. I didn't even deserve to have a son anyway. I never deserved to have a daughter anyway. And by the way, life is wonderful. Life is wonderful. I have children, 12 kids, 6 boys, 6 girls. I love my wife, love my family, love my church. I didn't deserve none of it. I don't deserve any of it. Brother, there was a time I looked for a truck to come and kill me, a car wreck to kill me. I looked for a heart attack to kill me. 58 years old, going to be 59 years old. I am still living, and I'm amazed at God's mercy on me. You hear me? I was a project boy on my way to hell, and I'm talking about in the stinking ghetto, and I'm talking about all I was thinking about God. All I was thinking about is girls. All I was thinking about is the nightclub, playing the bass guitar, had a scholarship to go to Brooklyn Music College, turned it down, and I surrendered to preach, and I hope one day I can pick it back up. My brother Ben's going to help me, and I can play some of that bass guitar, and I can blend in with the trumpet and the piano organ. But I've been wrapped up in preaching so long, I got so rusty, my fingers, I don't even know if I can find a note. I can do all things through Christ. Through Christ, I can do it. So when you see me playing the bass guitar a little bit, you understand. God's giving me some of it back, okay? But that's all. I was wanting to go to the top. To the top. That's all that was on my mind. To the top. Not for God, not for Christ. I got so tired of in that nightclub, all the stinking dope and the stinking liquor and all the stinking fast life and all that stinking junk, and I seen the heartache and I seen all that. And by the way, if you think it's all glamour, you better check out Hollywood. You better check out the divorces. You better check out the wrecked lives. You better check out the misery. You better check out the suicide, just in case you think that the right thing to do is forget Christ and not live for the Lord and not live for God. You better think twice, because I'm telling you, the best way is living for God. I don't change it. I don't change it for anything. I don't regret it for anything. I would change it for anything. God, I have joy. I have peace. God's blessed me with a wonderful wife. God's blessed me with a wonderful family. God's blessed me with a wonderful church. When I go back home into Connecticut, I'm talking about, you can choose your sins, but you can't choose the consequences. When I quit the band, I remember when I was playing the band, and they're snorting cocaine, it was doping it and drinking it. And I was going to church on Saturday night. I was going to the nightclub on Saturday night. And Sunday I was going to church. I just got saved. Saturday night, same thing. Clubbing. Sunday morning, church. Making money. I just got saved, friend. I didn't get mad at my preacher. I love my preacher. I didn't get mad and leave the church. And the Holy Ghost, God helped me. And God said, why don't you use that talent for me? And I did. I went to Bible college. I started playing Christian music. I go to Christian schools. I had concerts, and it was Christian music. And I said, I'll never forget during the summertime, was making money, was in the projects, we're in the ghetto, and they're trying to help the ghetto boys, you know, just to get off that stuff. I grew up at home with prison and drugs all around me and all kinds of, it was, excuse the expression, I don't really like to use this expression, but it was a scum, okay? Right? I don't, Brother Ben, he knows. They don't know the miracle that they're looking at right here, Brother Ben. And they don't know the miracle looking at you. They have no idea of the miracle, okay? But God knows. You know, Brother Ben. And I'm telling you, God was so gracious to me. He was so gracious. Graduate from Bible college. Call to preach. I don't want my children in our home. No way I want them to see some of the things we see. And to God be the praise. To God be the glory. And it's only His mercy and grace, friend. You're looking at a miracle. It's God's miracle. And you're looking up here as a pastor, but you don't know the struggle I had after I got saved. You don't know the struggle I had in Bible college. You don't know the struggle. But God does. God does. And God helped me to live that Christian life. God helped me. And we can choose our sins. David chose his sins, but he could not choose the consequences that would bring in his life. And when I go home, and even to this day, some of the guys I used to play in the band with, well, as soon as I got out of the band, the guitar player, she died in a car wreck with the guitar player, my friend. That could have been me. She's dead. If I would have chosen to stay, look at the consequence. That could have been me. That could have been me. The trumpet. God bless the trumpet. God bless you, Brother Dave, the trumpet. Brother Dave, they bashed his head in his brain. It hit him one time. He's died. He, as a teenager, he's dead. Brother Dave, dead. He was not even allowed to play the trumpet like you're playing it. Henry, are you understanding? Are you understanding, Henry? Then you need to get focused. You need to tune in. Because this thing is serious. As a teenager, he got his head, his brains busted in. And he's trying to sew him up. And he died. You hear me? After that blow in his head. That's the crazy, fast-paced life we live. You can choose your sins, but you can't choose your consequences. It's only by the grace of God that happened to me. I remember the saxophone player. I remember what happened. He lost his mind, walking the street crazy, and dope fried his brain. It's only by the grace of God. I'm telling you, when I go home and I hear about this one in prison, I hear about this one in jail, I hear about this one that committed suicide. And Brad Ben, it's only by the grace of God. I'll never forget what tears were crying. And I said, What happened? And I believe it was a teenager. You told me a friend put a rope around his neck and he hung himself. I'll never forget up in the stinking slums up there in the ghetto at New Britain, Connecticut. And Brother Ben was crying. And Brother Ben, that could have been you. That could have been my brother. That could have been him. It's by the grace of God you didn't do it. I'm no better than somebody to put a rope around his neck. Why don't you say it's by God's mercy? Why don't you say it's by God's grace? Somebody help me out. Help me out, please, and say amen. Have mercy upon me, Lord. Have mercy upon me, oh God. According to thy loving kindness. According unto the multitude. Let me hear you say multitude of thy tender mercies. Blot out my transgression. I shouldn't have done it. I shouldn't have done it. You know, a good true sign of the believer is after you transgress and after you sin, you feel bad. Do you know that's wonderful? Do you know that's your heavenly Father saying you shouldn't have done that? See, David tried to hide it like we do to Nathan the prophet. By the way, that's why I want you to read all the Bible. You see, Genesis to Revelation. See, you're missing it. 2 Samuel 10. This will help you out so much more if you study that chapter. 2 Samuel 10. Don't fall asleep. 2 Samuel chapter 11. Not now. I'm talking about on your own. Read 2 Samuel. Read David's blessings as a Goliath in his great victory as a teenager, in great victory blessings, and how God delivered him from Saul, and how God blessed him and promoted him to be king. God took a nobody, made him somebody, but he thought he was everybody. And the more you get, you got to be careful. The more you get, God's been good to you. Hey, then listen, be careful. The more you get, be careful. It's that time that sometimes that your own flesh and your own pride, you let your guard down. Amen. Be careful. You do things you never wish you'd done. And that's what happened to David. That's what happened to him, okay? He let his guard down. And God was so good to him. It's just greediness. He didn't need Bathsheba. He didn't need it. And guys, you know, there's a reason why so many mess up. Be careful. There's a lot you want to see in life. It's not for you to have. God has something better for you. We get so greedy. He didn't need her. Look how good she looked. Let me make this simple and plain and simple. God blessed him and used him to write. So many people have been blessed. God forgave him. God used him. God, friend, he learned to humble himself. He learned. Don't blame people while you're doing sin. Let me not blame you. Don't blame me. Don't blame your parents. Quit blaming people when you do. I'm talking about people, not all of you do this, but sometimes if we're not careful, we got to be like David and say, you're right. He was trying to hide it. The preacher, God sent Nathan the prophet. God knows everything. And the preacher, Nathan the prophet, listen, that's why I want you to know your Bible. I want you to know your Bible. When you read it in 2 Samuel, you see that God revealed it to the man of God, and God told him to go to David and let him know that he knows about this, and God exposed it. And that's why it's important to come to church, because God likes to reveal. And God, when you come to church, listen, I don't want to name a certain sin, because there's all kinds of sins. When you come to church, thank God. And that's why some people run from church. Don't run from church. Listen, God's running to you. God wants to help you. God wants to forgive you. God wants to use you. Don't run. Just say, you know, you're right. Man of God, you're right. David said, man of God, you're right. I'm trying to hide it, but he gave him the illustration about somebody that's something terrible. David said, kill that person. And Nathan the prophet says, you're the man. You did it. You did it. You want that person killed, but you're the one. Thou art the man. You know what David had to say? You're right. You can choose, thank you. You can choose your sins, but you can't choose your consequences. Sometimes it's death. If David didn't get right with God, he would have had a premature death. If David didn't get right, he would have died before his time. And many people die before their time. What a tragedy. Girls, I wonder how many times you could have got raped and killed, but God says, I'm not going to let you. Boys, I wonder how many times that God says, I'm going to take you out of this world. It might be a car wreck. It could be anything. It could be a drive-by shooting. I wonder how many people are alive. Have mercy upon me. I'm wrong. I don't deserve to live. I feel bad about it. I should have done it. Done what? Whatever you've done. There's things I've done. Sin, to him that knows to do good and doeth it not, it is what? I'm not even going to name your sin. I don't even name what God wants you to do. God used him. He was able to face the consequences and beg God for mercy and beg God to use him and beg God to give his Holy Spirit power in this psalm. That's why I want you to read this psalm today. When you go home, I want you to meditate on it. God used me again. God helped me. Lord, I know I don't deserve to live. And God blessed him. God gave him wealth. God gave him riches. God gave him freedom. God gave him a family. And you're not going to like this, but Solomon, the wisest man in the world, was born. At that time, where people from all over the world came and heard his son. What's going to happen to your son? What's going to happen to my son? What's going to happen to your daughter? What's going to happen to my daughter? You listen to me. You listen to me well. This is very important. If he had chose to not get right with God, I believe it had affected his son. Solomon? And friends, I'm telling you, it's more than just you being taken down by the devil. Hey, single boy. Hey, young man. What about your wife? What about your kids? Hey, dear teenage girl. Hey, young lady. What about your children and your children's children? I'm telling you, there are consequences. I beg you, let's be like King David. Let's be humble. And my people will call by my name, shall humble themselves. Look, 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 look. What makes you the difference? You go back to that rescue mission, and you humble yourself, and you beg God for mercy. You beg God for grace. What you do is you say, oh, God, oh, my God. That's why I give you the illustration of the person in the rescue mission. He was a millionaire. He lost it all. He became homeless. And they had him on the news. He was a millionaire. He lost it all. Then he became a millionaire again. That's why I tell you to be very careful how you treat these rescue mission people. We love them around here. Huh, that may be your boss one day. That might be the mayor. You might be looking at the president of the bank. You don't know. You have no idea. Be nice to these bus kids. They might be the pastor one day. Amen. Hello? Amen. Amen. Face your consequences like David did. Man up, woman up. You're a child of God. You know what's wrong. Amen. You know what... You know, if you're going somewhere, you should go. Do something you should say. Something you should say. Is there anything you say? I don't want nobody to know about that. God knows about it. God knows about it. But wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up. Come on. Come on. We all need this. We all need this. All right? Need to take time out. Confess sins. Be real. Everything's open into sight. All right? Have mercy upon me, O God, according to thy loving kindness, unto the multitude of thy tender mercies. Blot out my transgressions. Wash me. Underline this. Wash me thoroughly from mine what? Verse 2. Wash me thoroughly from mine what? Iniquity and what? Cleanse me from my sin. No father of the Catholic Church can cleanse your sin. Ain't no pastor can cleanse your sin. There's only one person can cleanse your sin. That is Jesus. Okay? And what I want you to do is claim his forgiveness. And don't beat yourself all up. And learn to forgive yourself. And learn to forgive others. Let's not bring up people's past. If God's forget them and cleanse it, why should we bring it up? Right? You're going to feel bad. Verse 3, for I acknowledge my transgressions and my sin as well. It's always going to be before you. But you, let me hear you say ever. Look. There's things in my past until I get to heaven. Now watch this. It's hard for you to comprehend this, but I believe it. God forgets it. We can't do that. God forgets it. He forgives and he forgets. Okay? He doesn't even remember it anymore. Now, I know it's hard for you to comprehend, but God says that in his word. Okay? You and I, in this human body, I'm remembering some things I did in my past. But I'm not going to beat myself up. God's forgiven me for that. I am going to try to help other people. I can't get bogged down on that. That's why people depressed, discouraged, and end up in mental institutions. But there are some things that help me to watch myself that prevent me from wrecking my life. Because I see what those things bring in my life. Are you understanding what I'm saying? You got to give people hope. There's a city out there, there's college students that wish they never did some things. They need help. Who's going to bring them hope? There's families out there. We knock on doors. They've done things that are terrible. Who's going to help them? Who's going to give them hope? Who's going to help that young lady? Say, look, God wants to bless your future, okay? You got burnt. You got hurt. You've done God wrong. But listen, man up, woman up. Say, God, I shouldn't have done it. God, forgive me. I wish I never did it. And I think about it. Lord, help me. And God will help you. And God will give you grace. And God will say, like he said to that woman, what you did, sin no more, lest the worst thing come upon you. And claim my forgiveness. And realize in the Bible, there's a Peter that cussed and cursed and did wrong. And God used him. There's a Jonah who ran away from God up in the whale. He thought he was in hell. And God used him again. He humbled himself. There's people in the Bible like Samson. Got his eyes plucked out. He lost his power. He was a young man, strong, had it all. But in his last days, he brought down the Philistines. And God used him one more time. Samson, you can have that. Woman, you can choose to rebel against your parents. You can choose to rebel against God. But Samson, you can't choose to get your eyes plucked out. Are you listening? Are you over here? Are you listening?
Amen.
Listen. One of my biggest fears. Wake up! Please wake up. One of my biggest fears. As I listen to the Bible on my phone, and I got to rewind it because I didn't understand. I wasn't listening to nothing that was being said. And I got to hit rewind on my phone. And that whole chapter I got to read again. What concerns me about you precious people I love so much.
Love you.
You know what concerns me? You missed the whole thing. And you wonder why your life ends up sticking wrecked. You know what I love you? What are you looking at her for? What are you looking at her for? You should be looking right up here. What are you looking at each other for? Yeah, you boys, what in the stink is going on in your mind? You don't know nothing I'm saying. Look at me. There's kids your age in prison for life. Look at me. Put a bullet in somebody's head. Your age sat here. It concerns me. So much here. So much here. I study this psalm. Study it, friend. When I say Psalm 51, everybody in this room ought to know. How are you going to help? How am I going to help my children? How am I going to help my church? How am I going to help my friends? If I don't help myself, you know, We're talking about a child of God here. We're talking about a child of God here. Okay? There's people in this room that know you're going to heaven. You know you're a child of God. You're saved. How are you going to help somebody that's on their way to hell that's not even saved? How are you going to help them that done things that are unthinkable? How are you going to help them when they feel they can't even, they shouldn't even come to church? That's how dirty they feel. How are you going to help them? If you can't let God forgive your sins and face your consequences and realize some of you are going through things because you disobey God, you disobey His word, and why don't you help me with these? Look at these young boys. Look at them. If before you know it, if they don't straighten out, they'll be paying alimony. They'll be paying alimony. They'll be paying child support. Does anybody care? These girls, it ain't going to be long if things don't change. They're going to lose their virginity before they get married. But does anybody care? Does anybody care that they got to deal with babies, daddy, mama, daddy, baby, mama, 1, 2, 3? They got to deal with child custody. Does anybody care? Does anybody care? Anybody care? So what? They go to divorce court. So what? They want to commit suicide. So what? They take their life. It's not my life. Stop being selfish. Somebody's got to care to keep them clean, to keep them pure. Everybody does it. Everybody does it. Everybody don't have to do it. You can be different in your society. A country where they're bombarded with the throwing the Bible out of school and colleges. A country where they're saying totally what God said different. And the universities and professors and philosophies. There's a whole different society that we live in. It's anti-God, anti-Christ. That mocks at the Bible, mocks at Christians. Well, how well are we doing? How well is society doing? How well is it? It's terrible. More shootings, more killings than we ever seen in our lives. It's a mess. Overdose is a mess. Dropouts in schools and colleges is a mess. Divorces is on the rise. Don't even have a family. Don't even have children. Hating life, hating family, miserable. Saying 10 years from now, climate change is going to blow up everything. You ain't going to be existing. You ain't going to be here 20 years. All this stupid, crazy junk. It's not Mother Nature's God. It's all in His hands. And I beg you this morning, be like King David. Face the consequences. You didn't choose them. You chose your sin, but you didn't choose the consequences. So you got to raise the children by yourself. Well, now is watch God bless you as a single mother. God bless you. Your husband walked out on you. The boyfriend that said, I love you, was the same one that slapped you, that hit you, or went with somebody else. What are you going to do? You can choose your sin, but you can't choose your consequence. I mean, what are you going to do? You chose to drink, you chose to smoke, the dope, you chose to run the light, the party, whatever it is. You want all the girls, you want all the boys, you chose it. Now face the consequence. Face it. You choose sodomy, there's consequences. I just hope that you would be like King David and let God use you. Let God use you. Some of the greatest Christians are some single mothers and single dads. Some of the greatest Christians, they've been divorced. Some of the greatest Christians, they used to be prostitutes. Some of the greatest Christians, no doubt, used to be pimps or whatever. Used to be dope dealers. But they got right with God. They begged for mercy. I can't imagine Brother Johnson in the penitentiary. I cannot even imagine Brother Johnson in the penitentiary. But Lady, I cannot imagine him in penitentiary. He spent years. Guess what he's doing now? Going down into the jails. Into the jails. Trying to help them. Well, Eddie, it's your choice, man. It's your choice. He's trying to sell it. He wants you to stay in church and serve God, love God, avoid a bunch of sticking mess he had. Or you can go and do worse. What a tragedy. Okay, I don't believe you are, but you can make that choice. But there's consequences. You go date someone who loves God, don't want to serve God. She's pretty, she's beautiful, and all this stuff. And end up like Samson, that's your choice. But you can't choose those consequences, Eddie. You can't choose it when you're paralyzed. You can't choose it when you want to commit suicide. You can't choose it when the doctor says, I can't give you no more medicine. Amen. That can help you. Let's bow our heads in prayer. I just want to help you. I just want to love you. I just want to help you. I just want to love you, okay? I'm here to help you, not to hurt you. You understand that, right? I want God to use you. You understand that, right? You need to learn to forgive yourself. Let God forgive you, okay? Look, there's some things I've done I don't even want you to never know about it. And there ought to be some things in your heart and life you don't want nobody to know about it. And I'm glad I don't know about it. But I'm glad that God forgot about it. And I'm so glad you ain't got to bring it up to me. And I'm so glad I ain't got to bring that up to you. And by the way, quit comparing yourself with people. When you stand next to God, your righteousness is filthy rags, the Bible says. Rotten, stinking rags. Hello. So just be careful when you're kicking somebody. Just be careful that God will start kicking you around. Amen. Brother Johnson, I don't even want to know. They tell me, brother. Man, they said, Eddie Johnson? They said, that man? No way. Church? Huh. Him? Yeah, him. The man's been saved. The man is a different man. He's a different man. And Brother Johnson, let me say something to you, okay? And I want to encourage you. Okay? And I want you to know this out of love in your heart. You're human just like anybody else. I'm not justifying anything, but just. But I look at your positives. And I thank God. I praise God. I just thank the Lord, Brother Johnson. I mean that. We love you. Thank God you ain't what you used to be, Brother Johnson. Any all I can say is thank God you got a daddy. And you got a mother back there. Sister Johnson, I say thank you. We love you, Brother Johnson, Sister Johnson, so much. We miss you when you're not here. I mean that. I would not have been able to ever meet Heather and had influence in her life. Lord, Eddie would not even be here. Eddie, you wouldn't even be here. Eddie, we love you, man. You know that. We're hard on you. Brother Johnson, we're hard on him. He's graduated from high school now, man. We're hard on him. We just don't want no whore girl to ruin him. And we don't want him to ruin some girl and become a whoremonger. Don't want to have him get some stinking sexual transmitted disease. Or end up in jail one day in prison. So we're just trying to give it everything we got, screaming and yelling, trying to keep it straight around here. You know, I know it's tough on him. He knows it. But I'll tell you what, Eddie, first year of college, I'm thankful you're in church. I'm thankful you're fighting, man, okay? I'm fighting for you, Doc, okay? Just don't let that stinking phone ruin your brains and fry your stinking brains, okay? Just don't go on them sites that's supposed to use what's gone. And when these guys want to look at it, tell them, it's not good for you, it's not good for me. Because you're going to stick and wreck your life. You preach to them. All right? Okay? That's for the rest of them got them phones. Deanna, you remember. Things haven't changed, has it, Deanna? Things haven't changed, has it? It hasn't changed. You remember when you were their age? You remember when you were young? You remember this little kid around here? It's just Deanna. A same old preacher behind this pulpit. Am I telling the truth? I ain't changed, have I? Amen. We love Deanna. We thank God when I seen you come through the door. I want the best for you, okay? Your future. And Brother Dave, he's new here. Brother Dave, and he came, and he sees all this stuff. And thank you, Brother Dave. You're thinking about your future, and God bless you. We're praying for you all the way, man. Good decision you made, okay? And these consequences that come into your life, whatever it is, whatever you've gone through in life, whatever has happened, everybody's got to pass, everybody. I will say this. As you look to your future, there's no telling how God will use you and bless you. As you let him, like King David. Amen. Says Natalie and your family, what a blessing. What a blessing in this year, to see what God has done. You know? Isn't it wonderful to know that God used King David to help millions of people? How much he'll use you and your children. Isn't that right? Let's pray. Father, I thank you and I praise you and I give you the glory and honor for helping these precious people. I thank you so much. We don't want nobody to go to hell, Lord. Thank you for these Christians that pray. Heads are bowed, eyes are closed, friends. Let me ask you a question. How many of you are 100% sure when you die you're going to heaven? How many of you are 100% sure you're going to heaven? Would you raise your hand? Thank you. You can put it down. How many would say, I don't know I'm going to heaven? If you don't know you're going to heaven, would you raise it? Okay, right here, one, two. That's good. That's good. You want to get that settled. I appreciate that so much. God bless you too. Brother Tim, would you come and to the altar? I want these two to know they're going to heaven and pray with them. Okay? You other Christians, come and pray. You come on and pray. You know, you be an example to these that need to be saved. You come on, Christians. You ask God to forgive you for whatever. You can help them, okay? Be an example how to talk to God, okay? Laurent, if you got a moment, we got one right here. He needs to know he's going to heaven and pray with him right over here in front, okay? Just ask God whatever you need to ask him for, you know, for forgiveness, for help, okay? Yes, sir. He needs to know he's going to heaven, okay? My friend, do you know you're going to heaven? Do you know you're going? Good, okay. I just want to make sure everybody knows, okay? That's good. That's wonderful, okay? Because once you're saved, you're always saved. You know that. God loves you forever. You understand that? You taught right. Good. Great. Whatever you need God's help in, yeah, he wants to help you, okay? All right? Yeah.